welcome to our series of special episodes of Talks at GS, where we're going to be speaking with some of the world's greatest investors. And today, my guests for this episode are Antoine Flamarion and Mathieu Chabran, the co-founders of Tikehau Capital. So Antoine and Mathieu, I'm really, really excited to have you join us to discuss your investment outlook at what is clearly an unprecedented time in the global markets. So thank you so much for being here.
Thanks for having us, Alison.
Thanks for having us, Alison. A great pleasure to be with you.
So Mathieu, you were in New York City through the pandemic, launching a business, hiring people, raising capital, and making acquisitions. So where are you focused now, looking at both sides of the Atlantic, across asset classes, across industries and geographies?
Yes, you're right, Alison. You know, this is timing, you know, being in New York at the start of the pandemic, you know, to launch a business. But it's been a great, you know, great experience to actually kickstart, you know, our North American operations at that time, because that gave us, you know, opportunities to effectively settle down, hire people, you know, we even acquired a business, you know, during the pandemic, and effectively be ready for when effectively we would get outside of this situation, of this pandemic. And ironically, you know, that's starting post the change in administration. There's a kind of reset, which creates opportunities for people like us, you know, having been hopefully focused on our people first. That was key. Focus on our portfolio companies. Obviously, you had to go through this crisis. And last but not least, you know, focus on the roadmap. And I think that's where we are at this stage. We really believe, Alison, in the structural tailwind for private markets, you know, given the macro environment, you know, we're in. We want to focus on these strategies. Those are private credit, obviously. Those are real assets, real estate with all the question marks around that, but infrastructure, massive play, particularly here, you know, in the US. And this minority private equity investment, which is effectively what is lacking, certainly, you know, in Europe, where we don't, you know, companies are lacking the equity base. And as much as there is a lot of capital to acquire a company, we're trying to develop a real strategy to provide capital, you know, to company, you know, and help their expansions.
So it would not be a chat with great investors in 2020 or 2021 without talking about SPACs. Antoine, I'm curious about how you view SPACs as an investment opportunity from both sides of the Atlantic. We saw that you just announced your own SPAC, and I know that you can't specifically talk about your own vehicle, but give us your views on the market, specifically in Europe.
Our view is that it's a good tool to have and to use to finance companies. So we decided to launch a series of SPAC partnering with Bernard Arnault. And Tikehau has a culture of partnering with, you know, companies, individual. We announced last year that we launched an aerospace fund partnering with Dassault, Airbus, Thales, for instance. And I think, you know, part of our DNA is really partnering with people. And I think in this SPAC environment, because, you know, it's really becoming a super hot topic. Everybody is about SPAC. You've got, you know, probably 200 news a day now on various SPAC. So we really see that as a tool to finance companies and really in an industrial way, i.e., you know, you have to find the right companies. And obviously, Europe is very late. Stock markets are really, much, much narrower than the US. So hopefully, you know, the SPAC will help a company to transition and grow. And we really see that as a good way for us and for the companies to grow.
So let's pivot to ESG. And Mathieu, can you tell us a bit about how Tikehau has historically incorporated ESG into your strategy? And also tell us about your energy transition fund that you just closed with over €1 billion raised.
Our approach has always been, you know, that if you step back to 2015, the Paris Agreement, right? Since we've been celebrating the Paris Agreement, there were some very ambitious goals set at the time. And as we celebrated the fifth anniversary, we realized that we are still, you know, lagging by far, because people realized that by switching off the global economy for almost, you know, 9 months, 12 months, that only reduced by 5%. The 51 billion tons of CO2 or greenhouse gases emission that we're effectively producing. So the issue is not about, you know, switching off the economy. It's not about not taking a plane anymore. It's about effectively directing those global savings. And we only need, you know, 10% of the 80 trillion of asset management to effectively tackle the issue. So that's what we've been trying to address, to be, I guess, you know, fairly innovative. Because when we launched this fund that you were referring to in 2018, not many people understood the rationale. You know, we started with our own balance sheet, 100 million euro. We always do that. Skin in the game is paramount, even more so, you know, for this very important topic. And then, you know, we closed a few days ago at a billion plus euro for a first time fund. But, you know, all this concept no longer makes sense. It's about effectively capturing this global saving, directing them to the real companies, the real SME, where we can effectively boost their ability to reduce this GHG, this greenhouse gases emission, and then make an impact. And for us, it's not about doing more or less ESG. It's about making impact institutional.
So I want to pivot a little bit to talk about creating the right investment culture, which you clearly have. And I want to talk about your careers as investors. So Antoine, starting with your entrepreneurial journey, following a stint at Goldman and founding Tikehau, you've both built something that started small and has now grown enormously since founding the firm in 2004. So can you talk a little bit about that journey? And we also often hear from successful entrepreneurs about moments of doubt that they had along the way. So were there ever any periods where you questioned if you could actually make it?
We touched base earlier on skin in the game. As we described, you know, we think that really investing your own money in your various investment vehicle is a key to the success. So, you know, we had tons of moments of doubt, and we continue to ask ourselves questions all the way along. And I will let Mathieu comment on the pronunciation of Tikehau in the US, for instance, because people used to say Tikehau. So, you know, it takes a lot of time. But, you know, if you put a lot of drive, energy, you continue to be curious, successful.
So, Mathieu, I'd love to get your perspectives on this. Your business started in Europe, right? And it's grown to include offices in Asia and in the US. So can you walk us through the global expansion and what advantages and challenges that presented?
So Europe was, you know, a must. We had to be able to demonstrate for then our Asian partners, investors, and today our North American investors that we had, you know, a differentiating story to tell. That effectively we were not one of those other managers who effectively tells you they can address Europe, but we try to do it in a fairly different way. We mentioned some of these key differentiating factors, you know, about the skin in the game, about this, you know, being local. But this expansion, Alison, you know, has been some kind of, you know, normal step. You know, we're going to be soon opening in Germany, for example, which was the last jurisdiction, the last country where we didn't have a local presence in Western Europe. And then, you know, we have, once again, a real differentiating story to tell.
So Antoine, if you could think back on your career, what would you say is the greatest investing lesson that you learned from a particular deal, whether it's a deal that went well or a deal that ended up not going so well?
So maybe I take as a first example, you know, our first deal back in 2004, we purchased the flea market in Paris. And at the time, you know, we just launched the firm with 4 million. And the first deal was a 26 million. And, you know, we always say, you know, think big. And we said, okay, we think big, 26 million. We only had 4 million. And, you know, we start discussing with investor and we ended up having Goldman Sachs co-investing with us. In a flea market in Paris, which I must say was fairly unusual for a first deal, a specific deal. And, you know, it was really a contrarian deal. And it turned out that, you know, 12 months later, the Duke of Westminster came to see us buying the flea market. And that's enabled us to do three times multiple for a first deal, having Goldman as a co-investor in a first deal. So it was great. Buying a flea market is not really a usual real estate deal. So probably be contrarian be the first lesson. And the second lesson is really think big, because this deal was too big for us and almost impossible to achieve, you know, having 4 million and buying something for 26 million. And so, you know, put some ambition. And I think then, you know, a little bit of luck, a lot of work, and that enabled us to achieve a great thing.
What do you think has been the key to your own individual investment success? What characteristics do you each have that has led to you being great investors? And maybe we can start with Mathieu on that.
Listen, some key principle of, you know, the obvious one, you know, being curious, you know, thinking out of the box, but more importantly, you know, never take anything for granted. You know, you should not do the job because someone else is giving you a rating, someone else is giving you an opinion, someone else is giving you an overview, and that, you know, particularly this time, you know, in the cycle now, I would say, you know, Alison, which has been once again very accommodating, is critical. You know, it's painful because, you know, when every day you have to make sure that everyone is a little bit stressed, you know, and not just take some the tailwinds of the market and the accommodating, you know, policies, and that's something I guess that has made us or made me effectively disciplined, you know, in that respect. And now we're trying to replicate that with the new people who join us, you know, the people we train, the people, you know, we give exposure to as early as possible. You know, as much investment banking where we started, you know, was a great way to learn the business, you know, to get trained. We really think that you cannot cheat with experience. Let me put it this way. And be a deal experience, be a client experience, be an investor experience. That's when you grow up.
So Antoine, what do you think has been the key to your success as an investor?
We are lucky because, you know, we are two founders, but we share the same view on how to be successful at investing. And you know, we are, you know, curious, first of all. Each time when we look at a situation, we are fairly agnostic, i.e., you know, we are not really following the trend. And as I said, you know, we'd rather create than compete. So I think, you know, be curious is one. Pay attention to detail seems very obvious, but you know, when you do a deal, you've got tons of people advising you, the best law firm, the best accounting firm, the best strategic firm, the best investment banks, and you know, you have to make your own judgment, and it's always challenging because, you know, when you receive a nice presentation, a nice pitch book on a company, on a deal, you know, you always say, yeah, probably right, you know, this company has the right characteristic, blah, blah, blah. And I think always be curious, don't be complacent, continue to be in the current context. And I think that's been a key for the time being for our development, our success.
My final question for both of you is, what advice would you have for someone starting out in investing today that you wish someone had told you when you first started your career? Antoine?
Probably be more offensive, you know, i.e., you know, continue to think big, be ambitious, because, you know, very often when you're ambitious, it doesn't seem that you're very humble. But you can be humble and be ambitious. So that would be my answer.
Okay. How about you, Mathieu?
It's never too early. Don't be shy.
Kind of similar theme. That's great. Well, Antoine and Mathieu, thank you so much for doing this talk with me. It was absolutely fascinating. So stay safe and stay healthy.
Thanks so much.
Thank you very much, Alison. Thanks for the time and your question.